The story of the Convair 880 and 990 is one of ambition, innovation, and ultimately, a bittersweet chapter in the history of aviation. In the 1950s and 60s, the airline industry was in the midst of a golden age. Jet engines were transforming air travel, making it faster and more accessible to millions of people around the world. In this competitive environment, every aircraft manufacturer was striving to create the next big thing. Convair, a company known for its military aircraft, decided to enter the fray with a new series of commercial jets. This would lead to the creation of the Convair 880 and its successor, the Convair 990. The Convair 880 was born out of a desire to compete with the giants of the industry, like Boeing and Douglas, who were dominating the market with the Boeing 707 and the Douglas DC-8. Convair's engineers aimed to create an aircraft that would be faster and more efficient than its competitors. The result was the Convair 880, named for its cruising speed of 880 feet per second, which equates to about 600 miles per hour. Launched in 1959, the 880 was designed to carry around 88 to 110 passengers, fewer than its rivals, but it was marketed as a niche aircraft, ideal for airlines that wanted to offer faster, more premium services. The aircraft's sleek design, with a narrow fuselage and smaller wings, contributed to its high speed. It was indeed one of the fastest commercial jets of its time, with a cruising speed higher than the Boeing 707 and the Douglas DC-8. However, this speed came at a cost. While the Convair 880 was fast, it wasn't as fuel efficient as its competitors. It also had a smaller capacity, which limited its appeal to airlines that were looking to maximize their passenger loads. Despite its impressive speed, the 880 struggled to find a significant market share. Only 65 units were built, and the aircraft failed to meet Convair's sales expectations. Undeterred by the challenges faced with the 880, Convair decided to try again with a new model, the Convair 990 Coranado. Introduced in the early 1960s, the 990 was an attempt to address some of the shortcomings of the 880. It was slightly larger, able to carry more passengers, and featured an extended range that made it more suitable for long-haul flights. The 990 also introduced several innovations, including anti-shock bodies, or speed pods, which were placed along the trailing edge of the wings. These pods were designed to reduce drag at high speeds and improve fuel efficiency. However, like its predecessor, the Convair 990 also faced an uphill battle in the marketplace. The improvements in capacity and range weren't enough to sway airlines away from the more established models from Boeing and Douglas. Additionally, the 990's development was plagued by delays and technical challenges, which only added to its struggles. Convair only managed to sell 37 units of the 990, bringing the total production of both the 880 and 990 to just over 100 aircraft. Financially, the 880 and 990 programs were disastrous for Convair. The company lost hundreds of millions of dollars on the project, which ultimately led to Convair's exit from the commercial aviation market. The Convair 880 and 990 were soon overshadowed by more successful models from their competitors, and they became rare sights in the skies. Yet, despite their commercial failure, the Convair 880 and 990 left a lasting legacy. The aircraft were beloved by pilots for their speed and handling characteristics. Some aviation enthusiasts and historians also view them as engineering marvels, aircraft that pushed the boundaries of what was possible, even if they didn't achieve commercial success. The Convair 880 and 990 also played a small but significant role in pop culture. Perhaps most famously, Elvis Presley purchased a Convair 880 in 1975 and named it the Lisa Marie after his daughter. This plane became a symbol of Presley's larger-than-life persona and is still on display today at Graceland, his home in Memphis, Tennessee. In retrospect, The story of the Convair 880 and 990 is a reminder of the risks and rewards of innovation. These aircraft were ahead of their time in many ways, but they also highlight the challenges of bringing new technology to market. They are a testament to Convair's ambition and a fascinating footnote in the history of aviation. A story of speed, ambition, and the relentless pursuit of progress, even in the face of daunting odds.